means you got to wait a while. How many of a modern day's church need to learn how to wait on God? How many know God is not a microwave God? Sometimes you got to wait on your deliverance. How many know some of y'all already healed and you don't even know it yet? You think God will come this way. But how many know that God, he's coming when you're not expecting him? But I have somebody in the house today. Just all shut door. Yeah. You got to get up out of here. I got the authority. learning about the Lord. Don't be in a hurry. This is a marathon and not a sprint. Now I'm talking to somebody in this house today. Tell me your name is a neighbor. You might have failed, but you're not a failure. You can get back up again. How many know that you have enough power to get up? You have a lifetime guarantee.
Yes.
How many realize that your record is in heaven? And God has written it. How many realize the county that you was born in has your birth certificate? But how many know you got a heavenly birth certificate?
All right. Thank you, God.
All right. And how many realize when it lists who your father is? God, Elohim, El Shaddai. Is your father.
Yes.
And how many know the seal has been sealed on it?
Right.
And how many know it's a guarantee,
guarantee
that no matter what you go through in this life, you're going to make it on the other side.
Yeah.
But how many realize we have to learn how to wait?
Yes, sir. Right.
Woo. Yes, sir. We have to learn. Y'all can sit down for a minute. I'm getting old. You have to learn how to wait. How many know in your patience possess you your soul? Can I just get a witness in greater hope this morning? Have God promised you something and it haven't come yet?
All right. Yes.
But it's on the way.
This side is good. Let me talk over here. God has promised you something you haven't received yet. But how many realize that what he promised? God said it's closer than hand and feet. Away from your promise.
You.
Who am I preaching to in here? You're one hallelujah.
You.
Away from your promise.
Thank you. Thank you.
And I see God tell the disciples, he says, tarry here in the city of Jerusalem till you be endured with power from on high. And how many realize when he told them this discourse, the Bible says that Jesus didn't catch no plane. He was just elevated in front of them. And he began to go up to heaven. And they saw him going up. And the angel that was standing at the foot with him, he said, "You men of Galilee, why sit ye here gazing up? That same Jesus is coming back again." How many believe that today? If God said it, I believe it. And that's what all that matters to me. How many know that God said, "You shall be blessed"? on the brink of a blessing. And they're worried about what people say. I don't care. Can I walk back just a little bit here? They don't care when I walk away from you. I don't care what my life used to be. I don't care how many mistakes I made in my past. I stop by to give a proclamation to you today. My past is dead and buried. I dare you to tell your neighbor up in here, say, neighbor, I've had the funeral already for my past.
All right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Out into the cemetery for my past.
All right.
And not only that, but I did the doxology at the graveside.
All right.
Ashes to ashes. Dust to dust. Yeah. I ain't got no help in here. Yeah.